10 years ago when I arrived here as the representative from Adams County, which is the home of Gettysburg, where I like to say America was saved, I was invited to this Civil War ball, which I knew absolutely nothing about. And I thought, well, you know, if it's Civil War ball, I should be here. So I showed up and I met a gentleman at that time by the name of Representative Harry Readshaw. And one of the things that he told me is that on the battlefield, all the states must maintain and repair their own monuments. As you'll notice when we go through the budget, you will not find a line item there to maintain the monuments for Pennsylvania on the battlefield. Harry took the lead on this 20 years ago and started an endowment fund for the maintenance and repair of these monuments. And I'll tell you, a better ambassador for Gettysburg and the battlefield you will not find. Harry is truly a true friend and a patriot. I'd like to actually turn this over to Harry right now because this was Harry's project. Harry started it, Harry deserves the credit for it, and Harry should speak on it. I want to commend Harry Readshaw for what he's done with this Gettysburg Battlefield Monuments project, and I'd like to call him to the microphone now.
Representative Readshaw.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Before I say a few words, I would like to introduce some guests. They are to my left, Larry and Annette Keener Farley, and the gentleman in the stovepipe hat is Governor Curtin, and he looks remarkably well for all these years that have gone by. Thank you for being here. On April 20th, 1997, we began the Pennsylvania Gettysburg Monuments Project by resolution. And at that time, like so many of you, and I'm sure you can equate to this, I simply read an article in the Pittsburgh Post-Gazette, which indicated about the disrepair of the Pennsylvania monuments, and including all the monuments at the Gettysburg National Battlefield. And like so many of you, at the time I thought something should be done, little did I know it was going to be me. So on April 20th, 1997, we, by resolution, as I said, began the Pennsylvania Gettysburg Monument Project, and it has been quite a journey. And to begin with, our goal was to, in working with the National Park Service, to repair, restore, and preserve 146 regimental markers at the battlefield, which were in need of repair. And here we are 20 years later, and our effort now is to endow those monuments at the Gettysburg Battlefield, which are not endowed. And here again, I'd like to emphasize our interaction with the National Park Service. When we originally began the project, they told us that we had to raise $184,000 to repair, restore, and preserve those monuments that needed such activity. We accomplished that. And now, as so many of you have experienced, you accomplish something and you say, well, well done. But the Civil War community and the reenacting community came to me and says, we should endow those monuments which are not endowed. So we called the National Park Service and they informed us that we needed $500,000 to endow the monuments that were not at that time currently endowed. So we raised $184,000 to repair, restore, and preserve. We're now at a $500,000 figure. We are around $400,000 that we have raised for endowing those monuments at the Gettysburg Battlefield. We refer to them as icons of freedom. And the challenge is for us not only to preserve these monuments and endow these monuments for future generations so they indeed can understand and preserve the history, not only of Gettysburg, but the part of Pennsylvanians in the Civil War. So it was my idea, but I can't take all the credit because, as you well know, along the way, and as we take this journey, no matter what it might be, we have many, many people that assist us. At the time, we challenged every school in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania to do book readings, 5K races, whatever they thought appropriate. And two of the, I want to mention three groups which have been very, very not only supportive, but annually have activities that raise funds. One is the Victorian Dance Ensemble. We'll have a Civil War ball here in the Rotunda next Saturday. They have been with us raising funds for 14 years. And the Abate Motorcycle Group, they have been with us in September when we take our annual ride from Harrisburg to Gettysburg. I don't want to stand before you and belabor the point. I am honored that this resolution is presented, and I honor and respect and thank Representative Mao for his remarks. So I encourage you, if you have interest in assisting in this effort, please contact me, speak to me. And the Gettysburg Battlefield Preservation Association, who, when we established this, was the nonprofit which was needed, happens to be the oldest preservation group in the country. They act as a nonprofit where all the money goes through. Eventually, repair and restoration went to the National Park Service, and right now we're endowing these monuments for future consideration. So I thank you for your attention. I thank you for Representative Miles' remarks. I thank you, Mr. Speaker. And we only have $100,000 to go, which hopefully, before I leave the building, we can accomplish. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.